lecture loops. As we have already studied the topics like operators, variables and data types, so now we are ready to make various programs related to this. So in this video I am going to cover 4 practice questions for you, and I suggest that you make these programs by yourself, but I have also provided the solution in the video. Okay, so you can tally the answers with those solutions. So without wasting time, let's begin. So first practice question is that you have to make a program to find simple interest when principal rate and time are given. So there is a very simple formula for simple interest, that is P into R into T divided by 100. So we can take as input from the user the values like principal, rate and time, and then we can simply apply this formula and find out the simple interest. Okay. So yes, now we'll make a program to find out the simple interest. So what are the variables that we need? Then we need interest, principal. So P, R and T. These are 3 variables. And one variable also we need for, you know, simple interest, int SI. Okay. So these are the variables. Now we have to take input from user. Principal, rate and time. Here I have used this scanner class, okay, and for that you have to import this java.util.scanner, and I have created here a new object with this keyword new, and this system.in is the input stream, okay, so that you know we can get the input. Okay, so to take input we will call the method of this scanner class, which is next int. Now we will find out the value of SI, that is a simple formula we are going to use, P into R, because it is a simple interest, so we'll use a simple formula. Okay, P into R into T divided by 100. Okay, now we're going to print this. Simple interest is equal to SI. Yes, and that's it. Enter principal, rate and time. So we'll enter 5000. Then suppose 8. Then 2, and yes, we are having this simple interest as 800. Okay, yes, so our next practice question is that we have to make a program to swap 2 variables without using the third variable. Okay, so we have basically 2 variables, A which has a value 30 and B which has a value 20 as an example. Okay, now we have to swap the values, means the value of A should be into B and the value of B should be transferred to A. Okay, so how we are going to do this? If we directly transfer the value of A to B, then it will override this value 20 and 20 will be vanished and only 30 will be there in these in both the variables. So and also we cannot use any third variable here. Okay, so we cannot temporarily store one of the value inside a temporary variable. So what can we do? So there is a simple you know arithmetic calculation for this that we can do. Suppose we can write A equal to A plus B, then what will happen? A plus B means 30 plus 20, which will become 50. So A will contain now 50. Then we will write A equal to, then we will write B equal to A minus B, that is 50 minus 20. So B will become 30. 50 minus 20 is 30. Then again we will write A equal to A minus B. Now A will become 50 minus 30, that is 20. In this way the values will be swapped and transferred without using third variable. So this is the simple formula that we can apply, and so let's code. So we will take only 2 variables here, suppose int A and B. for simplification, I'm just initializing the values of A and B here only. We are not taking input from the user. You can take input from the user also. Okay. So what we have to do is like A equal to A plus B, then B equal to A minus B, then again A equal to A minus B, and here we will print the values, compile it. Yes, A equal to 30 and B equal to 20. So we have successfully swapped these values. Okay, so now this is our third practice problem. Here we have to make a program to generate all the possible two-digit numbers from the digits of a given two-digit number. What does it mean? Don't get confused. Basically, if you have given a number 34, for example, then it has two digits like 3 and 4. So the unit's digit is 4 and the tens digit is 3. Alright, so we have to make all the numbers with this combination. So one can be 43 and one can be 44 and one can be 33. We have to make only two digits numbers. So 0, 3 and 0, 4, these are not allowed. Okay. And both the digits must be present. So 40, 30 like this. These are also not allowed. Okay, so in this way, how we can make these numbers? So the simple is, first of all, you have to extract these units and tens digits first of all, and then you can make these numbers. Like first number can be units place into 10 plus tens digit, that is units digit is, you know, 4, so it will become 4 into 10 plus 3, that is 43. And the next number could be u plus 10 units digit plus u. So it will become 44. And the third number can be tens digit into 10 plus t, and it will become 33. Okay. So how we are going to extract these digits, units place and tens place? So this is very simple. If we divide this number by 10, then we will get like this. So in quotient, we are getting the tens digit, while in remainder we are getting the units digit. So this is the hint for this particular practice question. Now you can solve it and code the program. This program is a little bit complicated as compared to two previous practice problems. Okay, but we will definitely solve it. So first of all, we will take input as number. So input number, that two digit number that we have to take. Okay, so take a variable as int unit, and in this we are going to take the units digit of this number. How? We know that the units digit is, we can get when we divide it by 10, and the remainder is actually the units digit, and the tens digit is actually the quotient. Okay, so when we divide this number by 10, the quotient is will give us tens digit and the remainder will give us the units digit. Okay, so we have these two digits, unit digit and tens digit. Now we have to make a different combination of the the numbers. Okay, so first number, that will be the reverse number, that is equal to, here we are going to multiply units number with 10, and then we will add tens number. So in this way we will get the reverse number. Okay, and the second combination is that is of only the unit number. So okay, we can say that is UU. Okay, so that will be unit into 10 plus unit number. Okay, and the third one is TT, that is actually tens into 10 plus tens. Okay, that's all. Now we have to print all these. We have to print all these values. Okay, so yes, the different combinations are these reverse UU and TT. So we are going to compile it and just see the output. So suppose the number input is 56, then we will see different combinations are here 65, 66 and 55. So this is our practice question 4, and in this question we have to find the minimum number of notes for a given amount, and the notes available are of 2000 rupees, 500, 200 and 100. And there is one condition that amount must be a multiple of 100, and that we have to tell to the user that he should enter the amount that must be a multiple of 100, because the minimum number of note we are having is of 100 rupees. Okay, so how we are going to find it? So first of all, we will start dividing the number with the maximum number of note, the maximum amount of note, which is 2000. So when we'll divide, we see that it is like, okay, so there are three notes of 2000. So in the quotient we get this number, that three notes of 2000. Okay, so when we will divide the amount with 2000, okay, so we will get the number of notes for 2000. Okay, then what we have to do, we have to also find the remainder. Okay, this remainder is also important. So again we will divide it with the next available note, that is 500, and then we will divide it and it is like 1500. Okay, 5 3s are 15 and then we get 100. So here we get three notes of 500 and we will get zero notes of 200 actually, because when we will divide it with 200, then we are going to get quotient as 0, and then again we will divide this remainder with 100 and then we will get the amount as 1, and here the one note of 100 again, and this is the method. So again and again dividing the amount with 2000, then with 500, then 200 and then 100, you can get the number of notes of a particular amount. Okay, so this is the basic hint for this practice question 4. So you can go and make a program and start coding. So that we are going to take is the amount, let's take it as AMT, and that we are going to take from user. So we will write next INT. Yes, like this, and also we'll ask user. So we will also write a print message here. So it is enter amount, okay, in the multiples of 100. Okay. Yes, that's it, and now we have the amount. So first we will calculate the notes of 2000. Okay, so notes 2000 is equal to actually the amount divided by 2000. Okay, that's it. We will also find that amount is equal to amount mod 2000, because we need the remainder also. Okay, then int notes 500 is equal to amount divided by 500. Now we have to give the output. So system dot out dot println is notes. So let's see guys, enter the amount in the multiples of 100. So suppose it is 7600. Then 3 notes of 2000, 3 notes of 500, 0 notes of 200 and 1 note of 100. So it is perfectly correct. So I just want to check one more thing. So I am going to again execute it. Suppose I enter an amount like 600, then we'll see what happens. Yes, so 0 notes of 2000, 1 notes of 500, 0 notes of 200, and 1 notes of 100. Again, the output is correct. So, in this way, our program is executing perfectly. So, that's all. If you understood all these programs, then please press the like button. And also, I will suggest you that please subscribe to my channel to watch more useful videos like this and quality videos like this. Okay, so thank you very much.